Motorrad step on it.
One of the changes is you don't have to disconnect the keel now, right? So you can go through this whole process without pulling the keel out, putting it back in.
Very, very important, which some people forget, is this this rope, which secure the left and the right side. Then the next is the control cable.
What's going on in there?
Raising the door up on the other side.
Oh, okay. Like, man.
Ben Carabino.
Sounds like a mad scientist.
Closed. And another security buckle.
Hell yeah. Wow. Now, which model glider is this?
BR Plus with air brakes. Okay. It's the super, super big one.
So, we prepare the nose.
Come on over here, get a close-up of this. This is going to be new to him, too. So Felix, let him get a close-up of the nose process.
You know, if I didn't think I had a shot at flying sometime today, I'd be three beers deep right now.
There's definitely a chance.
I like that.
There's definitely a chance.
It's the only thing that keeps me...
It's too bad you can't fly this one because you're so light. Fat bastard like me could probably do it.
This is a guide which you put in here because the nose latch should match this fitting and without this guide.
Did you reinforce the nose for roof landings?
I'll tell you what, before he goes, we'll
Kevlar coating on the nose.
So what we'll do is
penetrates a little bit easier.
Tight it with the banshee. And now I can bring the wing forward. There's a bit of a trick. So when I lift it up to get the keel away from the ground, because if the ground there are stones, it can rotate. Here is not necessary, but if it's stony, not just pulling forward, lift it up. And then you go.
Snap right into place.
I usually fix it right away. You can do it later, but at least this pin never removed before it's secured, in order to not forget. Because with this pin you couldn't finish the glider with the nose cap, so I leave it on till it's completely stored. This I put out. Now the bag. Getting in the small bags, usually I put in my harness.
Hey,
what is it with this? This is you remove after
a safety, just so you know you put the pin in later.
Do your final piece.
And pull that down. The big bags, the best is not close the zipper, just takes time. I not leave it on the ground. I take it, and in this situation, I put it in the spa.
Hey Felix, before you going further, the bags are different, right?
Sorry, there are two different bags. One have a padding, so I go on purpose from this side to this because when I later disassemble the glider, I disassemble here. I want to grab this bag and pull it out, and it's not so.
Nice.
So if you make it different, doesn't matter, but it's good to have a system and to know this bag has the extra padding because this stays with the keel. If you miss the paddings, you have the wrong side. And now, this is important, many people put the bags away right away. It's good it's on because now it's protected as long as possible. And when this wing is ready, then I continue here. So I need the winglet. Maybe you can bring me the winglet. The left one
up,
with the
it's
red.
Up there. Didn't we put it up?
Did Tommy buy a VR or VQ?
VR Plus.
And is a VR Plus a larger version?
Mm-hmm. It's the VR with these the longer aluminum.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Therefore, I go here. in from the outside. I open the Velcro, the first big steel for the Velcro, in order to hold this tube in the center of the gravity. So the, it makes the handling easier.
So get a video of that opening, the specific space that you opened up. That's the only place.
And here I have a hole. Maybe you can you can film this in here. I go in here with the hand to grab the tube and push it in. Right. Now it's not in. Now it's in. And you see the mark.
Okay. Thank you.
When it's in the same time I grab here the leading edge, the carbon leading edge. Pull it out, not completely, but just as far as I can grab it. The position so that it lines up with the winglet. There's an extra Velcro to fix it. There's also Velcro inside. I push it back to this Velcro and I have it on this Velcro, so it's fixed. Next step is I have the inside here. Maybe we can go with the camera in here. The tip tube. I have here a tip tube which I fix completely in with the Velcro.
Right there.
Okay. And the next step is I pull up. I place the sail by having my fingers here in order to not touch. Grab the Velcro too early and the sail lines up here. Close this and it stays like this. Now I have to fix three ribs with the pins. Putting in the pin, secure it. The other one. The third one is hinged. On the leading edge, and usually I don't open the Velcro because you have this hole and have access, and you can put the wing in here, so you save a bit lifetime of the Velcro and do the same inside. Now I move this in. Okay, this side is ready. So we go for the other side.
The glide on something this big, you need the air brake, it's going to be really nice.
Especially for Tommy.
What's Tommy?
I should put another set on it.
We never know what can happen to any of us, so.
Yeah.
Now it's good to come to the front. No, okay. The next step. I put the bag in here, and then do the same on the other side. After this, I finish this pulleys.
You guys are ruthless.
Okay,
everything is on video now.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
Yes.
I hate to do it, but I figured watch Felix set up anything else video, this would be good. So.
Exactly the same
airfoil,
like
no.
On the other side.
Fasten the ring tip.
Yeah.
And then the leading edge.
One Velcro here, one Velcro here.
Yeah.
Good, the two are fixed. So the next is the tip tube. Okay, now we need a confirmation from the front. Good is if this usually can stay always in place, like this. So you have to grab the lower pulley and bring it to the lower buckle. Take the next pulley and bring it to the middle. Center buckle and take the upper. You see here I have a bit of tension. I personally would cut this off. So it's just you don't need this extra length. And take care of the pulleys, can be like this. So if you I do a test like this, I fix it here in the clamp. And then you can pull, and this is a check, the pulleys are running. Mm-hmm. In case they are sometimes like this, you would feel, look, that you easily see. So this is a good check, like here, pulley didn't immediately feel, okay, they are running, it's okay, and now we can tighten. I tighten to the black mark, just a bit and recheck, okay, our ribs are out, the tip's looking good, tip insert, I not forget, and then it goes strong, I wind this a few times around of my hand and pull hard, then I go to the ring, and I bring this ring in, on the other side, the buckle. Be sure this buckle is completely in, and be sure you can easily hurt your hand if you clamp between. So you try this carefully and watch where's the best position for the fingers to hold. Be sure the pin is out, it's secured, and the ring is completely in. And this rope, if it's shorter, it's better, then you have no trouble. Otherwise, I open here a bit of Velcro and put it under this so it would slide somewhere around in the glider. The flaps, I pull one side of the string and bring in one pin, the other pin,
up, Ray?
I didn't hear you guys. There's the banshee. It's the same banshee we have here. I check that if this is open from time to time. I close this, not that it lines up, I close it, this in the position it stayed, just like this and ready. I do the same on the other side, and usually I do the pre-flight from here. I check the routing of the cable, and I don't come back. I go to the front and take off. Now we don't do, because we don't have the tail. Here would be good to have the tail. On the back right now, same on the other side.
Amazing how clean the air brakes are.
So you don't try to line up?
No.
Perfectly, no?
No, I don't try, because it moves around, it should find the position where the cell cut is made for.
It's an air brake.
I don't know if I checked it. The number?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
moving. Yeah, so that's the VR Plus, and I checked it.
I hope I have
to
see. No, I have to be in the front.
I'll check it.
Okay.
I checked the
D spar in the back.
This is Felix.
So yeah, check the serial number on the...
I thought it was going to be a boat.
It's beautiful.
It's the biggest heavy glider, but it's my size.
Many refinements. Very nice.
Jim Lamb.
Yeah?
No, it's terrible.
So feel that it's on by your fingers, by your thumb, and then slightly pull the rope tight. At the end you feel it's there's a scratching of the spring security. Scratching, okay, now it starts to get harder, and leave it. There's something new with the air brake.
Yeah, I want to see that installed now, that's the problem.
I have a rope. Coming from this side. Moving around this pulley. And be fixed here in the buckle for the air brake. Here's the other rope. Easy to see, big resource of the Technora cell. I open here. And put this in the buckle as well. Okay, I check. Okay, it's working.
Do it again.
Man, that is cool.
This is a check. I have to check the control cables, mm-hmm. if the routing is okay from the control pack cable, yeah. and if the routing is okay on the other side. But this usually I do once again before flight, because this is a very important point. The control cables go a bit hard, there's a trick. You can go with your knee and press it a bit too hard, because otherwise it's too hard to,
nice.
To make it.
Still use the tube in here?
Yes, still same tubing. Usually for myself, I go for takeoff, which is this mark. And in this position, I like to have a knot here. Because I fly like this, and this is best glide with the red the red mark is starting, the flap is up, and on the last movement, there's just, you see that just the tail is moving. And this is for a lower pitch. And I fly like this, have this on my thumb, and then you can enter the thermal, fly the thermal, and then you open, and usually I have this in,
wait,
I keep this.
What do you mean, just the tail is moving on the first part?
So this is better glide, better glide, better glide, flap is up. Okay, glide doesn't increase, doesn't improve, but the pitch is changing by moving the tail. So when I want to have less bar pressure, I open at quiet condition at a long final glide. In rough condition, I never let it go. I have it like this. I want to have a feel, a higher bar pressure. I have the flap up, but the tail, I like to have a bit of a bar pressure to react quicker to the turbulences. If the bar pressure is too light, I think the performance is getting worse because you cannot fly this exact. So I think for my feeling, the bar pressure has to be as high as possible for the best performance. This means I want to have it in fast fly here because in this position I can react very quick. I have my elbows on the harness aerodynamically. I don't want to have it here at 120, which is when I open it. I think here is a good, here is too much because then I go up with my harness. But you have to, I think you find your position for speeding so the bar pressure is as high as possible, but to stay comfortable down with your harness. For me, it's here. To keep it here, and here I speed, and here I do the final, and then I have it slightly on. Sometimes I get tired, I make a long final glide, I let it go, and I'll be on the, like this, on the speed bar. But normally, I have the tail
What about
set
when you're
up
on a car
extra
behind,
pitch.
On aero tow?
on aero tow, I recommend to start maybe 50% of the flap from the foot take off. Okay. And then, depending which aero tow you use, I was towing on the weekend on a Lambada, we had 1900 k towing speed. I opened completely, this was very nice to keep these two fingers going. But normally, I would say half flap, maybe one third of the takeoff flap. But you have to find out by yourself. At the first takeoff, you have to be prepared to open and find your setting for light bar pressure behind the track. Because it depends to your trim and to your body weight. But I think it's between half and 30% flap is perfect for flying, but you get out of the dolly. So be careful with this to hold the dolly tight, hold it for a long time, so that when you get out, you really fly, not spring out. Yeah. And to get out of the dolly, best would be to have the runoff setting. So I go between, set half setting, I have it a bit tight for towing, and in towing, then if I like, I release a bit. But this is something, it's very sensitive to your trim and to your weight, and I cannot give you a perfect recommendation, so it's really good to find it out for yourself, make a morning tow, go up in the altitude, and then find your setting, and then know, okay, this is my setting, I feel comfortable.
Also depends on the flight pattern, right? Some guys fly slower, some fly faster.
Okay, we do, before I put in a pre-flight here, this is very important because this is the bolts, the pins, have a ring here. This pin, I have to pull here a bit the rope. I see, okay, this pin has a ring. Normally I don't touch it, so it has to stay, but I check it. And the main bolt are secured all with a pin, right. This I see. Main bolt secured with a pin, this pin, so and here, just only, I don't see here, now you see it.
Oh yeah. Okay. And this rope doesn't interfere with the table anymore?
No,
no issues.
No. If, okay. Yeah, there was one safety issue,
right.
We had this pin longer, but it was very hard to put in, and if you make a check of the control system, which you can do like this, lift the wing, and you see this?
Yeah.
Is rising this spoiler, and the other side this spoiler is rising, and you hear it's working fine. Another thing where you feel it better, so I lift it here in the center up, and I go with my leg, one side, other side.
Yeah.
And then you have a good feeling for the movement and you see the rope moving. Yeah. And if you would see it's here under buckle and then it would be.
The rope was shorter so last time?
On a pre-flight you're not can make anything, but we changed it, that should be not. But this is a important serious point, check this also as well, check twice. It's tightened, you're routing of the cable here.
Yes.
This was happened a few times, get switched, always check before flight, routing
around
of the
rope,
cable
right,
here,
around,
and routing of the cable here.
Yeah.
Could you check the, show us how to check the spoiler arms to see if they're working again with your foot? I missed it.
Lifting up?
Yes.
One side?
Okay.
Full deflection? The other side.
Thank you.
Did you order skids or I didn't order anything?
Okay, then if the air brake, you can check the air brake by looking, watching here.
Yeah.
Okay, they work and they go back. The same I check, I have to look when I watch inside that the cable are running straight. and then I do double check here as well. I have this.
Oh, there's a clip there? Okay.
The sponge is on the way.
Uh-huh. Okay. How do you hold the air brake? Or you always hold it with your hand?
No. For flying?
Yeah, when you're in the air.
Maybe you hold
it
a
little. Behind you, okay.
That's so.
Oh my god.
So I'm coming in from landing and I have the air brake just here in my SAM.
Okay.
And then I decide, need less glide. I pull and I grab and I fly, less glide. Okay, I'm getting too low. I let it go.
Yeah.
And I go more down, then I pull it. But I'm not flying with one hand and with this because you cannot control it. So you have best is to use two positions. Coming down, hold tight, and coming down with a less glide. And if you see you need more glide, you fly, you continue
so
like this.
So it's all or nothing?
All or nothing. You can do between, but it's not it's not necessary. And for landing, this is why I don't have it like this.
Right.
Not, don't do this, have it in your SAM.
Okay.
For lifting the glider, many people go to the low A-frame. So to protect your back, it's good if you do it like, go to your knees with straight back and lift it up like this. And then you can go with your is your neck, this glider is the maximum tail heavy, but even in this glider, I need not much load to rotate it. Just a little. And then you can also go with a straight back and you can lift it. And when you land, I do the same for carrying. Open the flap for landing position and carrying like here. Because if you're carrying in front, it's too tail heavy. And going out of the glider, better like this, because if you try to lift it with your harness from here, it's not comfortable for your back. Because the A-frame is smaller than you are used to in a flex wing. And for one thing, if you carry the glider around, even good pilots do this from time to time. Usually you land always full flat. So you walk and you have the full flap on. Never do this because you will.
Yes.
And then you, the next thing you like a beetle, you will be on the back of your glider because you. So landing, go back, open this. If you walk against the wind, it's sometimes good to have a bit flap on. And in this position, you don't step on it. And it's better to walk. That's the most heavy glider if you try, because it's a 14.5 span plus the air brake plus, but
that's as heavy as you
with
can
me
get
as
with
the most heavy guy, it fit perfect.
But that's the heaviest combination you
the
can
heavy,
have.
Heaviest combination.
So since we're videoing, can you give us landing recommendations, flap settings and technique with this keel versus other keels?
Okay. Flap recommendation, full flap always, because I want to be trained to land in the shortest field.
Mm-hmm.
Having the rope here, not stick, can flip out. Always put it the rope in front of the control bar, because if it's flapping in the wind and you're stuck with the harness, it stays.
Mm-hmm.
So for the landing technique, it's hard. Maybe can hold me the glider. I can show you on the A-frame. One right, one left.
Hold it at the corner bracket here. Yeah.
If you come in, I go up there quite early, and there's plenty of time to switch. The good pilots go to the very end, and since they go up, it's, if you're trained, okay. Me not. Yeah. I think it's better first fly to go up early. Don't go like this. You have plenty of time. Just go like this. Go like this. Rotate, and then in this position, I keep speed. And for landing, very often I see that people don't level and fly along the ground. I think it's good to have minimally 10-meter level flight on the ground with your legs nearly scratching to feel how the bar is moving forward, getting weak and pushing. And if you come to the ground, install, because you grab too high and your harness is not prepared to get up, then you lift yourself up, your shoulder is here. You don't get it back. Next thing is you rotate and grab it here and push it forward, and you're in a stall and you grab down. So try it in the air up high, go slowly, and when you are on a final glide on the ground, go slide up with the both hands. But check this technique before. No need to make it in the ground. It's very good to make it up high. And if you manage to have a 10-meter smooth glide on the ground, I think more than 50% of the landing is done.
Well, Bill, talk about with the full climbing heel and the new sweep. Talk about for pilots that are moving from the glider with the aluminum, what's going to be different?
I think in flying, it's not much different. You just feel it smoother.
Landing,
the last weekend, yeah, I changed and said, wow, is this bumpy with the old gear? So it's much smoother. But on landing, it's more tail heavy. So don't worry that you don't push it out. But what the long gear don't like, if you push out, you cannot go vertical because it's too long. When you see I'm 1.90 meters, and if I push out completely, I go like this, not more. And the most people are a bit smaller, they go like this, not more. So I think in any case, it's good to make no landing really vertical like this and come down. So it's good to wait a bit longer and be prepared for a hard flare, but late. Then I come in like relaxed like this, wait, flare hard, the heel scratches, and you do 2-3 steps and the heel is scratching. So it's not really a big difference.
But the hang point further forward, the control frame compared to the aluminum steel, right? So it's going to feel different for the pilot.
Yes, but I think this, if you make the test in the air, yeah, how to get to the A-frame. Because if you do it in the ground, and you are used to having it here, and then it's here, but then you lose speed and drop, it's too late. But if you do it in the ground, check your position. With the carbon heel, the position is slightly more back. But it's hard to describe. Just do it when you're up high. Do the transition from down to up. Do it a few times. Do it slow. Do it if you like. Not by watching the side, okay. And because there's no need to get in a hurry. Even if it's rough, and I'm coming in 10 meter high. In rough air, I change it because you have full control up.
So then, when you fly this, right, it's going to feel different when you go upright. So, when you're on the aluminum keel, when you go upright, the bar can be out here.
Yes.
But the hang point is a little bit further forward. So, if you go upright on this, you're going to actually have to bring your shoulder blades back a little bit. But at the same hand position, you'll lower your hands down because the bar is closer and closer, right? And that changes a couple things, right? So, when you're used to leaning forward a little bit, it's going to be important to like arch your back. Back a little so you're more upright, but also when you flare, your hands the amount of pressure and the distance you go will change the air too. So that's, yeah.
I think the best place to flare is when you are in front of your shoulders, like we used with Malcolm, though it's better, I think. But before, some people have a problem if you go as high as they wish. Maybe they don't get up with the harness, so it's better to go lower. And I saw the mistakes very often in getting too high, pull up one side, putting automatically the shoulder in front, and now getting this by stalling. So better is go low, check this flight in the air. Here I'm comfortable, here I speed up enough. And when you have a level flight at the ground, by sliding up with both hands, I never saw a mistake from the people. That's more. But I saw very often a mistake by first hand too high, and then by the second hand comes the mistake. Because you don't get it, you're getting slow, you're getting unconcentrated. Oh, where is it? It's back. I have to push, or it's here or it's not.
And the like for like lighter, so like a VQ and a VQ race, for a dad who flies the older VQ, and he were to move to the VQ race stall speed, what's he going to notice that's different about the flying and the thermaling?
More or less exactly the same. Yeah, you feel the shaking in the lift comes a bit later because the tail is lifted up, so it's slightly, but most people don't recognize the shake from the tail because it's already in a point where you should not fly, where it's too slow. But shaking of the long heel is a bit later because we on purpose we lifted the stabilizer. We have the possibility to fly slower without getting a tail in the cortex of the wing. But I think that's nothing you have to consider. It's just fly, and after a few flies, you get automatically used to it. It's not very special. What is very special is what I told you before. I never opened the rope completely unless there's a real purpose for it. I think as much bar pressure as possible gives you the best feeling for the glider. When I'm flying with too much flap in the thermals, I'm too slow, I'm flying a thermal, I get rise, the nose rises in entering the thermal, then I open the flap, I fly more comfortable. So you have to find out the position. The position is take off or less. And for speeding in turbulent condition, I always want to have a very good, strong bar pressure. Strong means that it's just before I get up with the harness. I think here is a good position. Here I can control it, not here. Because here you enter turbulence and it suddenly dies and you get out and you have not the quick reaction as you have with higher bar pressure. So in turbulent condition, open the flap completely, but leave the flap up for maximum pitch. This is mostly the best setting to fly, with the best performance and most comfortable.
Is it possible to
flap
the wings?
So on the car, the angle, is better to be tail higher, or what do you feel? I mean, we use tail higher. Like,
any change from before?
So we make many tests, and I think the glider getting out of the dolly with about 9 degree, but we set the angle from the keel of about 11, 12 degree, so it's hard to measure, but just make it at smooth condition a takeoff, and I like it, the takeoff in this way. You start rolling, then the tail get lifted by this much, 20-30 centimeter above the support. And then, if you fast enough and you want to get out of the dolly, and you feel you get flying, get back and right, drop it, and then you get out, not this much, get out half a meter or 1 meter. And therefore you need the space. If you touch with the keel and get lifted in this area, then it can come to the mistake that you are not sure I'm fast enough or not. And you want to get out, but you cannot push because your angle of attack is limited. So it's good if you watch the takeoff, keel is supported, keel has to go before getting out of the dolly by 20 to 30 centimeter to have enough space to suddenly raise the ankle. Okay, I'm 1 meter away and I'm not touched down, because in the last time I know 4 serious accidents by getting out of the dolly and touchdown just beside or catching in the dolly or some stupid. So really, your dolly, I don't know how say in Germany they make some things that the dolly is just made with a very slappy rope. I want to have really a good grip, and I say this is my landing gear or my takeoff gear. This is my life. This is I want to have it as tight as possible, and I stick with this, and I want to have a good grip. It's very, very important. And once you are fast enough, better be faster, and you get fly, I want to drop it and I want to get away from it, but nothing between. And many takeoff where you so I get out, but I was just on the speed to get out, and the wind drop, then it comes to the accident. So
we had a guy on a VR that constantly, right after takeoff, made a left turn and somehow was able to save it, but at the end, he ended up crushing hard.
Which one is this?
Huh?
Which one is this?
Not here. But no, it wasn't here. But the question is, the angle of attack when you're on the cart, the flaps have to see the wind at some point to work, right?
Yeah. So I was in the opinion to have the angle very flat, and we tried it out many times, but finally we came not to a good result. It's better to be a bit more angle of attack, and then start pushing back, because I'm afraid, no, I'm not a runway like this, to getting in a hole. Once I'm rolling, I get into the front, and on the dolly I speed up, and then the tail is lifting out of the dolly and I fly. But this is why I control before you take off, this level, a bit steeper is better. A bit more flap is better, and some mistake I see very often is when you have crosswind, when you have the wind from this side, and the people like to compensate the swing and hold the wing down, and say run a few steps, and this way the spoiler is activated, and then you over control. The spoiler brings it down, and then you come out of the dolly if you don't have it. If you have 20k cross, you can practice a takeoff. This would be very good to film, demonstrate. You have 20k from here, you have your wing like this, and everybody would say it's stupid. But I start running with the wing up high, because then the spoiler get deflected, and the glider find its neutral position by itself, and it continues very, very smoothly. If you do it the opposite way, it will turn and can push you out of the dolly. So it's no need to go like this, but definitely not lower. So the wing in the wind has to be slightly higher. And usually you do this in a wrong way. And there's another thing we found out on an airport. We made some with smoke, checked out the vortexes. And when you come in the vortexes from the trike, suddenly the wing can go to the side, because it's hitting the vortex of the prop at one side. And so the tuck pilot at this airport say start from the side, started with full power, then the first thrust go to the side and turning in. And this seems like was an improvement. They do, it was not a problem for single gliders, but for tandem gliders, and they do it in this way. But I think I don't know if it's really necessary, but
you want a nice positive separation from the dolly. You don't want to mush out of it. I'm not so sure about the pull in and then depend on the pilot to know when to push out. What if you just get in the right position and stay there? Don't let go, but stay there until it's a positive separation.
So you always have a...
I see the mistakes are when people pull in, because they don't, it's fine if they know exactly when to push out, but they don't know exactly when to push out. So get them in the right position and stay there.
Yes, it's maybe more simple to know, show the people the position, where is the position.
And then stay there.
The position to get out is when your nose is at the control bar. And I think this is good to say.
Hold on to the dolly.
Hold the dolly, hold your nose on the control bar and wait. And then
you can lift the dolly off the ground.
Well, so I was going to say that the right time to get out of the dolly is when it's in the air with you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When the dolly's, you know, 12 inches off the ground,
if people pull in, they don't.
As soon as you let go of the dolly, right? Now you pop up and
they push out too late. A lot of the dollies.
If you have a positive
angle of attack, starts to shimmy, and then it's like putting on the brakes.
Yeah,
and you have half flaps. Okay.
And all they had to, you know, they stay on the dolly too long.
To get
things get crazy,
you know,
and they've got plenty
first.
Of speed. To,
Felix,
they've got plenty of speed to fly,
as
but they aren't
a
bit higher angle.
You always want to be hanging onto that rope tight, okay?
Yeah.
And then if you just hold that position while the
Pull in.
You'll
get in the right
plane
spot.
Accelerates,
and stay in the right
you'll start to
I
lift
do it usually,
the cart.
I'm,
then you,
we have small pulleys.
You know you're good.
Rough
you just let go of it.
And so I start rolling like this.
You better feel.
To get not, to get not overflipped. Then I go to the neutral position to speed up.
So it's a VR plus.
Like in the air, I drop
beautiful,
it
huh?
But you know exactly when to push out. You know exactly when to push out, so that's why that works.